Hello friends, I'm Vikram Dewan, head of the digital team at Consumer Voice, and I have with me today Ms. Ankur Saha, who is the head of the legal help desk at Consumer Voice. Welcome Ms. Ankur for coming.
Thank you.
So Ankur, can you tell us about the Consumer Protection Bill?
Yes, so when we talk about the Consumer Protection Bill, as we all know that this bill will be replacing the Consumer Protection Act 1986. So this bill will enforce the rights of consumers in a more better way when a consumer hires or avail any services or buy any product or any goods. So the existing law which sought to replace the bill was the consumer jurisprudence, and this existing law is 32 years old. Last year it has completed 32 years in December 2018. So this is all about the bill.
So Ms. Ankur, how and when were the consumer courts actually set up?
So back in 1986, when Mr. Rajiv Gandhi was the Prime Minister of India, he pushed to set up this bill, and he was successful doing this hassle-free in Lok Sabha, and surprisingly within a week it sailed through Rajya Sabha. But then central government set up the national level court, but state governments were not so keen to set up the courts. So there was a public interest litigation initiated by one Mr. Shori, where the Supreme Court directed all the state governments to set up the consumer courts in all states.
So Ms. Ankur, can you please also elaborate on the three-tier court structure?
Yes, so when we talk about Consumer Protection Act, the most important thing is the three-tier system of law. So the three-tier systems are district forum and at state level, and another one is at national level. So these three tiers have different pecuniary jurisdiction. So in district forum, when a consumer is having a case up to 20 lakhs, he can file his case in district forum. If his case is above 20 lakhs and within 1 crore, he can file in state commission. And above 1 crore, he can go to national commission. The last court for appeal is Supreme Court after national commission.
And Ms. Ankur, do you think that the consumer courts have proved as a boon for the consumers, and can you quote a case law, explain with the case law?
Yes, definitely. Consumer courts have been proven to be a boon in all these years, as we all know that Consumer Protection Act and consumer courts are very consumer friendly, and the main reason towards the enactment of this act is to protect the consumers from errant service providers. When we talk about errant service providers, let's take an example of real estate players, where the home buyers are the most violated by the builders. So what they do, they invest their hard-earned money to buy a property, but then eventually they don't get the property, and these builders violate all their rights and everything. Recently the consumer court, the national commission, passed a very favorable judgment in last year, where it said that even if in builder buyer agreement the clause says that in case of any delay in delivery of property, the compensation to be paid would be rupees 5 square feet per month, but the court said that this amount of compensation, that is rupees 5 square feet per month, is in case of short delay. Mm-hmm. But then where the delay is prolonged or unreasonable one, mm-hmm. and where the consumer has, you know, waited unreasonably to get the possession of the property, he cannot just be okay with just rupees 5 square feet per month, because he has paid the amount as and when demanded. So he should not be in a compromising position. So the court has said that even if the consumer has accepted the possession, he can later ask for higher compensation from the one stated in builder buyer agreement. So this is a very favorable judgment, and it's been proven to be very, very advantageous for the consumers.
Okay, wonderful. So thank you, Ms. Ankur Saha, for coming us and talking about this topic, which is of great relevance for the consumers. Sure. And keep watching our channel for more such videos. So thank you, Ms. Ankur.
Thank you. Thank you.